Daisy had a little fawn. Deer and her fawn.
Chapter 1.
Once upon a time, in a beautiful forest, there lived a kind and gentle deer named Daisy. Daisy had a little fawn, her precious child, named Sparkle. They were a joyful duo, exploring the woods together and sharing moments of happiness. One sunny day, as they were grazing near a flowing river, tragedy struck. The forest was home to hunters who sought to capture and sell animals to people far away. One such heartless hunter named Mr. Stone had set traps in the forest to catch innocent creatures. As Daisy and Sparkle roamed freely, they unknowingly approached one of Mr. Stone's deadly traps. Suddenly, a loud snap echoed through the woods, and Daisy's leg got caught in the cruel snare. She cried out in pain, and Sparkle trembled with fear, not understanding what was happening. Desperately, Daisy tried to free herself, but the trap was too strong. Sparkle, full of love for her mother, attempted to help but was too small and powerless. Tears filled Sparkle's eyes as she watched her mother suffer. Meanwhile, other forest animals had noticed what was going on. The wise old owl, Mr. Hoot, gathered the woodland creatures to form a rescue team. They knew they had to act quickly to save Daisy and Sparkle. With the guidance of Mr. Hoot, the animals worked together to distract Mr. Stone, causing him to leave the area for a moment. They took this opportunity to approach Daisy and comfort her. Despite her pain, Daisy remained calm and told Sparkle not to worry. She urged Sparkle to run away and find safety. Reluctantly, Sparkle followed her mother's advice, fleeing deep into the forest as fast as her little legs could carry her. The brave animals tried their best to release Daisy from the trap, but their efforts were in vain. Eventually, Sparkle found a secluded spot to hide, her heart heavy with sadness and worry for her mother. She didn't want to leave Daisy behind, but she knew she had to stay safe. Back at the scene, the animals continued to struggle to free Daisy. But their rescue efforts were cut short as Mr. Stone returned, driven by greed to capture his prey. The hunter's heartlessness had taken away any chance of saving Daisy. Sparkle, hidden in the darkness of the forest, felt a deep sorrow she had never known before. She knew she would never see her dear mother again. The forest lost a ray of light that day, and Sparkle's life was forever changed. From that day on, Sparkle lived her life in memory of her mother, determined to be as kind and gentle as Daisy had been. The tragic story of Daisy and Sparkle served as a reminder to all the animals of the forest that they must protect each other from the heartless hunters and cherish the love they have for one another. And so, the forest continued to thrive, and the memory of Daisy and Sparkle's bond lived on in the hearts of all who knew their story.
Chapter 2.
As time passed in the forest, the memory of Daisy and Sparkle remained alive, passed down through generations of animals. They became legends, symbols of love, courage, and the unbreakable bond between a mother and her child. Sparkle, now a grown-up deer, carried the teachings of her mother in her heart. She had grown into a graceful and wise creature, respected by all the animals in the forest. Sparkle was known for her compassion, always willing to lend a helping hoof to those in need. Every year, on the anniversary of the tragic event that took her mother away, Sparkle would gather the animals in the forest for a special memorial. They would come together to share stories about Daisy, reminiscing about her kindness and the joy she brought to their lives. During these memorials, Sparkle would also share important lessons she had learned from her mother. She reminded everyone about the dangers of the outside world, urging them to be cautious of traps and the hunters who sought to harm them. Sparkle's words carried great weight, and her guidance helped the animals live peacefully in the forest, avoiding unnecessary risks. As the years went by, Sparkle became the forest's protector, continuing the legacy of her mother. She worked tirelessly to keep the animals safe from harm, forming alliances with other wise creatures like Mr. Hoot, the owl, and Bella, the wise old fox. One day, while patrolling the outskirts of the forest, Sparkle encountered a lost and scared fawn named Lily. Her big, innocent eyes reminded Sparkle of herself when she had lost her mother. Sparkle approached Lily gently, and with a soft voice, reassured her that she was safe. Sparkle took Lily under her care, becoming a surrogate mother to the young fawn. She taught Lily about the forest, its dangers, and its wonders. The two quickly formed a strong bond, and Sparkle promised herself that she would protect Lily just as Daisy had protected her. Under Sparkle's guidance, Lily grew into a brave and confident deer. She admired Sparkle and looked up to her as a role model. Together, they made the forest a safer place for all its inhabitants, helping the animals live harmoniously. As the years rolled on, Sparkle grew older, and her coat started to turn silver, a sign of her wisdom and experience. Lily now took on more responsibilities, and the forest animals saw a bit of Daisy's gentle nature reflected in both Sparkle and Lily. One winter, the forest faced a severe snowstorm that threatened to disrupt the harmony of life. The animals were struggling to find food, and many were in danger of freezing. Sparkle and Lily led the efforts to unite the forest creatures, ensuring that everyone had enough to eat and a warm place to rest. During this difficult time, Sparkle fell ill, weakened by the bitter cold. Her body had grown tired from years of protecting the forest and its inhabitants. As the animals saw their beloved protector's strength fading, they gathered around her, expressing their gratitude for all she had done. On her final night, Sparkle called Lily close and whispered, "You are now the guardian of this forest, my dear Lily. Carry on the love and compassion we've shared, and remember to protect one another." With those words, Sparkle closed her eyes and peacefully passed away, surrounded by the animals she had cared for all her life. Lily felt the weight of responsibility resting on her shoulders. She knew she had to honor Sparkle's memory and continue the legacy of love and protection in the forest. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle continued to inspire generations of animals to come. Their love and sacrifice remained etched in the hearts of all who called the forest their home, a reminder of the enduring power of family and the profound impact one gentle soul can have on an entire community.
Chapter 3.
As the seasons changed, the forest mourned the loss of Sparkle. The animals held a grand memorial to honor her memory, gathering together to share stories of her bravery and kindness. They vowed to carry on her legacy and follow in her footsteps to protect their home. Lily, now the new guardian of the forest, felt the weight of her responsibility. She sought guidance from Mr. Hoot and Bella, who had been Sparkle's trusted advisors. They shared their wisdom with Lily, teaching her about the delicate balance of nature and the importance of unity among the animals. Under Lily's leadership, the forest thrived. She was a compassionate and fair leader, always putting the needs of others before her own. Lily established an emergency food supply during times of scarcity and organized regular meetings where the animals could voice their concerns and work together to address any issues. As the years passed, Lily became known as Lily the Wise among the forest creatures. Her gentle nature and keen decision-making skills earned her the respect and admiration of all. She often thought of Daisy and Sparkle, the mother and child who had set the example for her to follow. During one particularly challenging season, a fierce wildfire broke out on the outskirts of the forest, threatening to consume everything in its path. The animals panicked, fearing for their lives and their homes. Lily knew she had to act quickly. She rallied the animals and devised a plan to create firebreaks, clearing away dry vegetation to stop the fire's spread. With each creature playing its part, they managed to contain the flames and protect their beloved home. In the aftermath of the fire, the animals realized the importance of working together, just as Daisy and Sparkle had done with the other forest creatures when trying to free Daisy from the hunter's trap. The bonds between the animals grew stronger, and they felt a deeper connection as a united community. Lily's leadership continued to be a guiding light for the forest. She encouraged the younger animals to learn from the wisdom of their elders and to cherish the stories of Daisy and Sparkle. Their legacy became a symbol of hope and resilience during difficult times. As Lily grew older, she knew it was time to pass on her knowledge to the next generation. She sought out a young fawn named Willow, who displayed great empathy and courage. Lily saw a spark in Willow that reminded her of her own youth and the strength she had gained from the lessons taught by Daisy and Sparkle. Lily took Willow under her wing and shared with her the stories of the forest's history and the values that had made it a harmonious place to live. She passed on the traditions, ensuring that the memories of Daisy and Sparkle would live on through Willow's generation. As the seasons turned, Willow, now a wise and compassionate leader, followed in Lily's footsteps. She continued to cherish the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle, nurturing the bond between animals and keeping the forest safe from harm. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle, the tragic tale that began with loss, transformed into a tale of hope and inspiration that echoed through the forest for generations to come. Their legacy lived on, a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the indelible mark left by two gentle souls who had forever changed the destiny of the forest and its inhabitants.
Chapter 4. As the years passed, the legend of Daisy and Sparkle spread beyond the borders of the forest. Their story touched the hearts of humans too, as it was shared by travelers passing through the nearby villages. The tale of the brave deer and her devoted fawn became a symbol of the precious bond between a mother and her child, resonating with people from all walks of life. Word of the enchanted forest and its guardian animals reached the ears of a renowned wildlife conservationist named Dr. Anna Carter. Driven by a passion for protecting endangered species and their habitats, she embarked on a mission to find the forest and learn more about its inhabitants. Guided by the stories she had heard, Dr. Carter ventured into the dense woods, determined to witness the magic of the legendary forest for herself. Along her journey, she encountered various forest creatures, each with their unique stories to share. They spoke of Daisy and Sparkle, their heroics, and the incredible leadership of Lily. As she delved deeper into the forest, Dr. Carter's heart swelled with awe and admiration for the animals and their harmonious way of life. The creatures of the forest had formed a remarkable community, living in peace and protecting one another, just as Daisy and Sparkle had exemplified. Dr. Carter was particularly intrigued by the wisdom and grace of Lily, who now had a family of her own. Lily's fawn, named Star, showed great promise and an eagerness to follow in her mother's footsteps. Dr. Carter observed the love and knowledge being passed down from one generation to the next, much like how Daisy's legacy had lived on through Sparkle and then Lily. Intrigued by the unique harmony of the forest and the wisdom of its animals, Dr. Carter decided to dedicate herself to the conservation of this magical place. She worked with local authorities to establish protective measures, ensuring that the forest and its inhabitants would be safeguarded for generations to come. Over time, the forest became a designated wildlife sanctuary, cherished and protected by those who had come to know its history and the lessons it held. Dr. Carter collaborated with scientists, educators, and environmentalists, using the story of Daisy and Sparkle to raise awareness about the importance of preserving natural habitats and respecting the delicate balance of nature. The sanctuary also became a place of research and education, where people could learn about the interconnectedness of all living beings. Students from nearby villages visited the forest, and its stories were included in school curriculums, inspiring the next generation to become stewards of the environment. As the sanctuary flourished, so did the memory of Daisy and Sparkle. Statues of the mother and child deer were erected at the entrance of the forest, serving as a reminder of the bravery, love, and sacrifice that had shaped the destiny of the enchanted woods. The forest thrived under the watchful eyes of its protectors, and the animals lived in harmony with nature, celebrating the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle through their daily actions. And so, the tale of Daisy and Sparkle, once a tragic story, had now become a beacon of hope and a catalyst for positive change. Their love and bond had not only inspired the creatures of the forest but had reached the hearts of people far and wide, leaving a lasting impact on both the natural world and the human spirit. The enchanted forest and its guardian animals remained a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the profound influence one gentle soul can have on the world.
Daisy had a little fawn. Deer and her fawn.
Chapter 1.
Once upon a time, in a beautiful forest, there lived a kind and gentle deer named Daisy. Daisy had a little fawn, her precious child, named Sparkle. They were a joyful duo, exploring the woods together and sharing moments of happiness. One sunny day, as they were grazing near a flowing river, tragedy struck. The forest was home to hunters who sought to capture and sell animals to people far away. One such heartless hunter named Mr. Stone had set traps in the forest to catch innocent creatures. As Daisy and Sparkle roamed freely, they unknowingly approached one of Mr. Stone's deadly traps. Suddenly, a loud snap echoed through the woods, and Daisy's leg got caught in the cruel snare. She cried out in pain, and Sparkle trembled with fear, not understanding what was happening. Desperately, Daisy tried to free herself, but the trap was too strong. Sparkle, full of love for her mother, attempted to help but was too small and powerless. Tears filled Sparkle's eyes as she watched her mother suffer. Meanwhile, other forest animals had noticed what was going on. The wise old owl, Mr. Hoot, gathered the woodland creatures to form a rescue team. They knew they had to act quickly to save Daisy and Sparkle. With the guidance of Mr. Hoot, the animals worked together to distract Mr. Stone, causing him to leave the area for a moment. They took this opportunity to approach Daisy and comfort her. Despite her pain, Daisy remained calm and told Sparkle not to worry. She urged Sparkle to run away and find safety. Reluctantly, Sparkle followed her mother's advice, fleeing deep into the forest as fast as her little legs could carry her. The brave animals tried their best to release Daisy from the trap, but their efforts were in vain. Eventually, Sparkle found a secluded spot to hide, her heart heavy with sadness and worry for her mother. She didn't want to leave Daisy behind, but she knew she had to stay safe. Back at the scene, the animals continued to struggle to free Daisy. But their rescue efforts were cut short as Mr. Stone returned, driven by greed to capture his prey. The hunter's heartlessness had taken away any chance of saving Daisy. Sparkle, hidden in the darkness of the forest, felt a deep sorrow she had never known before. She knew she would never see her dear mother again. The forest lost a ray of light that day, and Sparkle's life was forever changed. From that day on, Sparkle lived her life in memory of her mother, determined to be as kind and gentle as Daisy had been. The tragic story of Daisy and Sparkle served as a reminder to all the animals of the forest that they must protect each other from the heartless hunters and cherish the love they have for one another. And so, the forest continued to thrive, and the memory of Daisy and Sparkle's bond lived on in the hearts of all who knew their story.
Chapter 2.
As time passed in the forest, the memory of Daisy and Sparkle remained alive, passed down through generations of animals. They became legends, symbols of love, courage, and the unbreakable bond between a mother and her child. Sparkle, now a grown-up deer, carried the teachings of her mother in her heart. She had grown into a graceful and wise creature, respected by all the animals in the forest. Sparkle was known for her compassion, always willing to lend a helping hoof to those in need. Every year, on the anniversary of the tragic event that took her mother away, Sparkle would gather the animals in the forest for a special memorial. They would come together to share stories about Daisy, reminiscing about her kindness and the joy she brought to their lives. During these memorials, Sparkle would also share important lessons she had learned from her mother. She reminded everyone about the dangers of the outside world, urging them to be cautious of traps and the hunters who sought to harm them. Sparkle's words carried great weight, and her guidance helped the animals live peacefully in the forest, avoiding unnecessary risks. As the years went by, Sparkle became the forest's protector, continuing the legacy of her mother. She worked tirelessly to keep the animals safe from harm, forming alliances with other wise creatures like Mr. Hoot, the owl, and Bella, the wise old fox. One day, while patrolling the outskirts of the forest, Sparkle encountered a lost and scared fawn named Lily. Her big, innocent eyes reminded Sparkle of herself when she had lost her mother. Sparkle approached Lily gently, and with a soft voice, reassured her that she was safe. Sparkle took Lily under her care, becoming a surrogate mother to the young fawn. She taught Lily about the forest, its dangers, and its wonders. The two quickly formed a strong bond, and Sparkle promised herself that she would protect Lily just as Daisy had protected her. Under Sparkle's guidance, Lily grew into a brave and confident deer. She admired Sparkle and looked up to her as a role model. Together, they made the forest a safer place for all its inhabitants, helping the animals live harmoniously. As the years rolled on, Sparkle grew older, and her coat started to turn silver, a sign of her wisdom and experience. Lily now took on more responsibilities, and the forest animals saw a bit of Daisy's gentle nature reflected in both Sparkle and Lily. One winter, the forest faced a severe snowstorm that threatened to disrupt the harmony of life. The animals were struggling to find food, and many were in danger of freezing. Sparkle and Lily led the efforts to unite the forest creatures, ensuring that everyone had enough to eat and a warm place to rest. During this difficult time, Sparkle fell ill, weakened by the bitter cold. Her body had grown tired from years of protecting the forest and its inhabitants. As the animals saw their beloved protector's strength fading, they gathered around her, expressing their gratitude for all she had done. On her final night, Sparkle called Lily close and whispered, "You are now the guardian of this forest, my dear Lily. Carry on the love and compassion we've shared, and remember to protect one another." With those words, Sparkle closed her eyes and peacefully passed away, surrounded by the animals she had cared for all her life. Lily felt the weight of responsibility resting on her shoulders. She knew she had to honor Sparkle's memory and continue the legacy of love and protection in the forest. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle continued to inspire generations of animals to come. Their love and sacrifice remained etched in the hearts of all who called the forest their home, a reminder of the enduring power of family and the profound impact one gentle soul can have on an entire community.
Chapter 3.
As the seasons changed, the forest mourned the loss of Sparkle. The animals held a grand memorial to honor her memory, gathering together to share stories of her bravery and kindness. They vowed to carry on her legacy and follow in her footsteps to protect their home. Lily, now the new guardian of the forest, felt the weight of her responsibility. She sought guidance from Mr. Hoot and Bella, who had been Sparkle's trusted advisors. They shared their wisdom with Lily, teaching her about the delicate balance of nature and the importance of unity among the animals. Under Lily's leadership, the forest thrived. She was a compassionate and fair leader, always putting the needs of others before her own. Lily established an emergency food supply during times of scarcity and organized regular meetings where the animals could voice their concerns and work together to address any issues. As the years passed, Lily became known as Lily the Wise among the forest creatures. Her gentle nature and keen decision-making skills earned her the respect and admiration of all. She often thought of Daisy and Sparkle, the mother and child who had set the example for her to follow. During one particularly challenging season, a fierce wildfire broke out on the outskirts of the forest, threatening to consume everything in its path. The animals panicked, fearing for their lives and their homes. Lily knew she had to act quickly. She rallied the animals and devised a plan to create firebreaks, clearing away dry vegetation to stop the fire's spread. With each creature playing its part, they managed to contain the flames and protect their beloved home. In the aftermath of the fire, the animals realized the importance of working together, just as Daisy and Sparkle had done with the other forest creatures when trying to free Daisy from the hunter's trap. The bonds between the animals grew stronger, and they felt a deeper connection as a united community. Lily's leadership continued to be a guiding light for the forest. She encouraged the younger animals to learn from the wisdom of their elders and to cherish the stories of Daisy and Sparkle. Their legacy became a symbol of hope and resilience during difficult times. As Lily grew older, she knew it was time to pass on her knowledge to the next generation. She sought out a young fawn named Willow, who displayed great empathy and courage. Lily saw a spark in Willow that reminded her of her own youth and the strength she had gained from the lessons taught by Daisy and Sparkle. Lily took Willow under her wing and shared with her the stories of the forest's history and the values that had made it a harmonious place to live. She passed on the traditions, ensuring that the memories of Daisy and Sparkle would live on through Willow's generation. As the seasons turned, Willow, now a wise and compassionate leader, followed in Lily's footsteps. She continued to cherish the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle, nurturing the bond between animals and keeping the forest safe from harm. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle, the tragic tale that began with loss, transformed into a tale of hope and inspiration that echoed through the forest for generations to come. Their legacy lived on, a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the indelible mark left by two gentle souls who had forever changed the destiny of the forest and its inhabitants.
Chapter 4. As the years passed, the legend of Daisy and Sparkle spread beyond the borders of the forest. Their story touched the hearts of humans too, as it was shared by travelers passing through the nearby villages. The tale of the brave deer and her devoted fawn became a symbol of the precious bond between a mother and her child, resonating with people from all walks of life. Word of the enchanted forest and its guardian animals reached the ears of a renowned wildlife conservationist named Dr. Anna Carter. Driven by a passion for protecting endangered species and their habitats, she embarked on a mission to find the forest and learn more about its inhabitants. Guided by the stories she had heard, Dr. Carter ventured into the dense woods, determined to witness the magic of the legendary forest for herself. Along her journey, she encountered various forest creatures, each with their unique stories to share. They spoke of Daisy and Sparkle, their heroics, and the incredible leadership of Lily. As she delved deeper into the forest, Dr. Carter's heart swelled with awe and admiration for the animals and their harmonious way of life. The creatures of the forest had formed a remarkable community, living in peace and protecting one another, just as Daisy and Sparkle had exemplified. Dr. Carter was particularly intrigued by the wisdom and grace of Lily, who now had a family of her own. Lily's fawn, named Star, showed great promise and an eagerness to follow in her mother's footsteps. Dr. Carter observed the love and knowledge being passed down from one generation to the next, much like how Daisy's legacy had lived on through Sparkle and then Lily. Intrigued by the unique harmony of the forest and the wisdom of its animals, Dr. Carter decided to dedicate herself to the conservation of this magical place. She worked with local authorities to establish protective measures, ensuring that the forest and its inhabitants would be safeguarded for generations to come. Over time, the forest became a designated wildlife sanctuary, cherished and protected by those who had come to know its history and the lessons it held. Dr. Carter collaborated with scientists, educators, and environmentalists, using the story of Daisy and Sparkle to raise awareness about the importance of preserving natural habitats and respecting the delicate balance of nature. The sanctuary also became a place of research and education, where people could learn about the interconnectedness of all living beings. Students from nearby villages visited the forest, and its stories were included in school curriculums, inspiring the next generation to become stewards of the environment. As the sanctuary flourished, so did the memory of Daisy and Sparkle. Statues of the mother and child deer were erected at the entrance of the forest, serving as a reminder of the bravery, love, and sacrifice that had shaped the destiny of the enchanted woods. The forest thrived under the watchful eyes of its protectors, and the animals lived in harmony with nature, celebrating the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle through their daily actions. And so, the tale of Daisy and Sparkle, once a tragic story, had now become a beacon of hope and a catalyst for positive change. Their love and bond had not only inspired the creatures of the forest but had reached the hearts of people far and wide, leaving a lasting impact on both the natural world and the human spirit. The enchanted forest and its guardian animals remained a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the profound influence one gentle soul can have on the world.
Daisy had a little fawn. Deer and her fawn.
Chapter 1.
Once upon a time, in a beautiful forest, there lived a kind and gentle deer named Daisy. Daisy had a little fawn, her precious child, named Sparkle. They were a joyful duo, exploring the woods together and sharing moments of happiness. One sunny day, as they were grazing near a flowing river, tragedy struck. The forest was home to hunters who sought to capture and sell animals to people far away. One such heartless hunter named Mr. Stone had set traps in the forest to catch innocent creatures. As Daisy and Sparkle roamed freely, they unknowingly approached one of Mr. Stone's deadly traps. Suddenly, a loud snap echoed through the woods, and Daisy's leg got caught in the cruel snare. She cried out in pain, and Sparkle trembled with fear, not understanding what was happening. Desperately, Daisy tried to free herself, but the trap was too strong. Sparkle, full of love for her mother, attempted to help but was too small and powerless. Tears filled Sparkle's eyes as she watched her mother suffer. Meanwhile, other forest animals had noticed what was going on. The wise old owl, Mr. Hoot, gathered the woodland creatures to form a rescue team. They knew they had to act quickly to save Daisy and Sparkle. With the guidance of Mr. Hoot, the animals worked together to distract Mr. Stone, causing him to leave the area for a moment. They took this opportunity to approach Daisy and comfort her. Despite her pain, Daisy remained calm and told Sparkle not to worry. She urged Sparkle to run away and find safety. Reluctantly, Sparkle followed her mother's advice, fleeing deep into the forest as fast as her little legs could carry her. The brave animals tried their best to release Daisy from the trap, but their efforts were in vain. Eventually, Sparkle found a secluded spot to hide, her heart heavy with sadness and worry for her mother. She didn't want to leave Daisy behind, but she knew she had to stay safe. Back at the scene, the animals continued to struggle to free Daisy. But their rescue efforts were cut short as Mr. Stone returned, driven by greed to capture his prey. The hunter's heartlessness had taken away any chance of saving Daisy. Sparkle, hidden in the darkness of the forest, felt a deep sorrow she had never known before. She knew she would never see her dear mother again. The forest lost a ray of light that day, and Sparkle's life was forever changed. From that day on, Sparkle lived her life in memory of her mother, determined to be as kind and gentle as Daisy had been. The tragic story of Daisy and Sparkle served as a reminder to all the animals of the forest that they must protect each other from the heartless hunters and cherish the love they have for one another. And so, the forest continued to thrive, and the memory of Daisy and Sparkle's bond lived on in the hearts of all who knew their story.
Chapter 2.
As time passed in the forest, the memory of Daisy and Sparkle remained alive, passed down through generations of animals. They became legends, symbols of love, courage, and the unbreakable bond between a mother and her child. Sparkle, now a grown-up deer, carried the teachings of her mother in her heart. She had grown into a graceful and wise creature, respected by all the animals in the forest. Sparkle was known for her compassion, always willing to lend a helping hoof to those in need. Every year, on the anniversary of the tragic event that took her mother away, Sparkle would gather the animals in the forest for a special memorial. They would come together to share stories about Daisy, reminiscing about her kindness and the joy she brought to their lives. During these memorials, Sparkle would also share important lessons she had learned from her mother. She reminded everyone about the dangers of the outside world, urging them to be cautious of traps and the hunters who sought to harm them. Sparkle's words carried great weight, and her guidance helped the animals live peacefully in the forest, avoiding unnecessary risks. As the years went by, Sparkle became the forest's protector, continuing the legacy of her mother. She worked tirelessly to keep the animals safe from harm, forming alliances with other wise creatures like Mr. Hoot, the owl, and Bella, the wise old fox. One day, while patrolling the outskirts of the forest, Sparkle encountered a lost and scared fawn named Lily. Her big, innocent eyes reminded Sparkle of herself when she had lost her mother. Sparkle approached Lily gently, and with a soft voice, reassured her that she was safe. Sparkle took Lily under her care, becoming a surrogate mother to the young fawn. She taught Lily about the forest, its dangers, and its wonders. The two quickly formed a strong bond, and Sparkle promised herself that she would protect Lily just as Daisy had protected her. Under Sparkle's guidance, Lily grew into a brave and confident deer. She admired Sparkle and looked up to her as a role model. Together, they made the forest a safer place for all its inhabitants, helping the animals live harmoniously. As the years rolled on, Sparkle grew older, and her coat started to turn silver, a sign of her wisdom and experience. Lily now took on more responsibilities, and the forest animals saw a bit of Daisy's gentle nature reflected in both Sparkle and Lily. One winter, the forest faced a severe snowstorm that threatened to disrupt the harmony of life. The animals were struggling to find food, and many were in danger of freezing. Sparkle and Lily led the efforts to unite the forest creatures, ensuring that everyone had enough to eat and a warm place to rest. During this difficult time, Sparkle fell ill, weakened by the bitter cold. Her body had grown tired from years of protecting the forest and its inhabitants. As the animals saw their beloved protector's strength fading, they gathered around her, expressing their gratitude for all she had done. On her final night, Sparkle called Lily close and whispered, "You are now the guardian of this forest, my dear Lily. Carry on the love and compassion we've shared, and remember to protect one another." With those words, Sparkle closed her eyes and peacefully passed away, surrounded by the animals she had cared for all her life. Lily felt the weight of responsibility resting on her shoulders. She knew she had to honor Sparkle's memory and continue the legacy of love and protection in the forest. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle continued to inspire generations of animals to come. Their love and sacrifice remained etched in the hearts of all who called the forest their home, a reminder of the enduring power of family and the profound impact one gentle soul can have on an entire community.
Chapter 3.
As the seasons changed, the forest mourned the loss of Sparkle. The animals held a grand memorial to honor her memory, gathering together to share stories of her bravery and kindness. They vowed to carry on her legacy and follow in her footsteps to protect their home. Lily, now the new guardian of the forest, felt the weight of her responsibility. She sought guidance from Mr. Hoot and Bella, who had been Sparkle's trusted advisors. They shared their wisdom with Lily, teaching her about the delicate balance of nature and the importance of unity among the animals. Under Lily's leadership, the forest thrived. She was a compassionate and fair leader, always putting the needs of others before her own. Lily established an emergency food supply during times of scarcity and organized regular meetings where the animals could voice their concerns and work together to address any issues. As the years passed, Lily became known as Lily the Wise among the forest creatures. Her gentle nature and keen decision-making skills earned her the respect and admiration of all. She often thought of Daisy and Sparkle, the mother and child who had set the example for her to follow. During one particularly challenging season, a fierce wildfire broke out on the outskirts of the forest, threatening to consume everything in its path. The animals panicked, fearing for their lives and their homes. Lily knew she had to act quickly. She rallied the animals and devised a plan to create firebreaks, clearing away dry vegetation to stop the fire's spread. With each creature playing its part, they managed to contain the flames and protect their beloved home. In the aftermath of the fire, the animals realized the importance of working together, just as Daisy and Sparkle had done with the other forest creatures when trying to free Daisy from the hunter's trap. The bonds between the animals grew stronger, and they felt a deeper connection as a united community. Lily's leadership continued to be a guiding light for the forest. She encouraged the younger animals to learn from the wisdom of their elders and to cherish the stories of Daisy and Sparkle. Their legacy became a symbol of hope and resilience during difficult times. As Lily grew older, she knew it was time to pass on her knowledge to the next generation. She sought out a young fawn named Willow, who displayed great empathy and courage. Lily saw a spark in Willow that reminded her of her own youth and the strength she had gained from the lessons taught by Daisy and Sparkle. Lily took Willow under her wing and shared with her the stories of the forest's history and the values that had made it a harmonious place to live. She passed on the traditions, ensuring that the memories of Daisy and Sparkle would live on through Willow's generation. As the seasons turned, Willow, now a wise and compassionate leader, followed in Lily's footsteps. She continued to cherish the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle, nurturing the bond between animals and keeping the forest safe from harm. And so, the story of Daisy and Sparkle, the tragic tale that began with loss, transformed into a tale of hope and inspiration that echoed through the forest for generations to come. Their legacy lived on, a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the indelible mark left by two gentle souls who had forever changed the destiny of the forest and its inhabitants.
Chapter 4. As the years passed, the legend of Daisy and Sparkle spread beyond the borders of the forest. Their story touched the hearts of humans too, as it was shared by travelers passing through the nearby villages. The tale of the brave deer and her devoted fawn became a symbol of the precious bond between a mother and her child, resonating with people from all walks of life. Word of the enchanted forest and its guardian animals reached the ears of a renowned wildlife conservationist named Dr. Anna Carter. Driven by a passion for protecting endangered species and their habitats, she embarked on a mission to find the forest and learn more about its inhabitants. Guided by the stories she had heard, Dr. Carter ventured into the dense woods, determined to witness the magic of the legendary forest for herself. Along her journey, she encountered various forest creatures, each with their unique stories to share. They spoke of Daisy and Sparkle, their heroics, and the incredible leadership of Lily. As she delved deeper into the forest, Dr. Carter's heart swelled with awe and admiration for the animals and their harmonious way of life. The creatures of the forest had formed a remarkable community, living in peace and protecting one another, just as Daisy and Sparkle had exemplified. Dr. Carter was particularly intrigued by the wisdom and grace of Lily, who now had a family of her own. Lily's fawn, named Star, showed great promise and an eagerness to follow in her mother's footsteps. Dr. Carter observed the love and knowledge being passed down from one generation to the next, much like how Daisy's legacy had lived on through Sparkle and then Lily. Intrigued by the unique harmony of the forest and the wisdom of its animals, Dr. Carter decided to dedicate herself to the conservation of this magical place. She worked with local authorities to establish protective measures, ensuring that the forest and its inhabitants would be safeguarded for generations to come. Over time, the forest became a designated wildlife sanctuary, cherished and protected by those who had come to know its history and the lessons it held. Dr. Carter collaborated with scientists, educators, and environmentalists, using the story of Daisy and Sparkle to raise awareness about the importance of preserving natural habitats and respecting the delicate balance of nature. The sanctuary also became a place of research and education, where people could learn about the interconnectedness of all living beings. Students from nearby villages visited the forest, and its stories were included in school curriculums, inspiring the next generation to become stewards of the environment. As the sanctuary flourished, so did the memory of Daisy and Sparkle. Statues of the mother and child deer were erected at the entrance of the forest, serving as a reminder of the bravery, love, and sacrifice that had shaped the destiny of the enchanted woods. The forest thrived under the watchful eyes of its protectors, and the animals lived in harmony with nature, celebrating the legacy of Daisy and Sparkle through their daily actions. And so, the tale of Daisy and Sparkle, once a tragic story, had now become a beacon of hope and a catalyst for positive change. Their love and bond had not only inspired the creatures of the forest but had reached the hearts of people far and wide, leaving a lasting impact on both the natural world and the human spirit. The enchanted forest and its guardian animals remained a testament to the enduring power of love, unity, and the profound influence one gentle soul can have on the world.